الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. All praise be to Allah. Glory be to Him. We praise Him. With Him we seek aid and help. To Him we repent. By Allah, glory be to Him, we seek refuge from the evil of our souls and from our bad deeds and wrongdoing. Whosoever Allah, the exalted, guides, none can misguide. And whosoever Allah, Azza wa Jal, misguides, none can guide. I bear witness that none have the right to be worshipped but Allah, the exalted, alone, and that Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is His messenger and His servant. Allah, the exalted, has said, which translated means, O who you believe, fear Allah as He should be feared. And do not die unless in a state of Islam. وَالنَّجِمُ وَالشَّجَرُ يَسْجُدَانِ. We know before, we were talking regarding the stars and the trees, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glory be to Him, has created the stars, and we are seeing the stars, and we couldn't recognize that the stars are making sujood and doing sujood for Allah, prostrating to Allah Azza wa Jal in the matter of worship to Allah Azza wa Jal. Such as the trees, the different kind of trees are worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal and doing the sujood, prostrating to Allah in the matter of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We heard about the hadith that the tree was like making sujood and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reward it, asking Allah, glory be to Him, to save and to record the reward of this piece of sujood or sajda, and asking Allah to accept it with sincerity, such as He accepted that from Prophet David alayhi salam, peace be upon him. And also the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was adopting the same and following the same glorification of and same dua supplication of the trees, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reciting and doing that during his sujood. Also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asking, encouraging the Muslim, encouraging the Hajj when he is making talbiyah to say labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, inna alhamda wal ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. The Prophet ﷺ encouraged the Hujjaj to raise up their voice up loudly to while they are making talbiyah, to raise their voice loudly. Because why you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He can hear them. The Prophet said, ما من مسلم يلبي إلا لبى من عن يمينه وشماله من شجر أو مدر أو حجر. Whenever the Muslim making talbiyah and should raise his voice loudly, because nothing around him in his left side or right side, did no creature hear him from trees, from the rocks and trees or rocks, except following him and making talbiyah, repeat after him, min shajarin aw hajarin aw madar, from the trees, from the rocks. Like this rock, for example, are doing tasbih for Allah and doing glorification to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, respecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in the matter of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to respect this kind of creature. So we have to raise our voice loudly because they are following us. What that means, following us? Following us for the worship. So, and also in the hadith, the other hadith, when the Prophet ﷺ encouraged the Muslim or ordered the Muslim, whenever he, you know, whenever he is like from the desert or whenever he reaches the time for salat, to make adhan loudly and iqama loudly and pray. So the Prophet ﷺ was saying that no one hear your voice from the mankind or jinn or trees or rocks except following you, praying after you, and repeating after you making tasbih and making sujood. So that means all these creatures worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glorifying Allah azza wa jal, remember Allah and mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to thank Allah, and we have to recognize that we are not the only creature who worship Allah, or the only creatures who are like glorifying Allah. No, everything, such as the Prophet has said, there is not a thing between heaven and earth except knows and recognize that I am a messenger of Allah, and accept the sinners of the mankind of jinn. So these kind of trees are worshiping Allah, these kind of stars worshiping Allah, and doing this tasbih. In the authentic hadith, in the other authentic hadith, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was saying that تقاتلون اليهود حتى يقول الشجر والحجر يا مسلم يا عبد الله هذا يهودي ورائي تعال فاقتل. الشجر والحجر, even the trees, even the rope, believing in this عقيدة الولاء والبراء, they are according to the pleasure of Allah, they are worshiping Allah, fulfillment of the worship toward this kind of aqidah, the wala, to love for the sake of Allah, to hate for the sake of Allah, to ally for the sake of Allah, and to boycott for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. The Prophet ﷺ in this authentic hadith was talking that, and giving this, you know, news or this future news about the Muslims, that you will fight the Jews. You will fight the Jews before the end of this world, of this, you know, life and world. You will fight the Jews till the trees and the rocks, you know, saying, "O Muslim, O a believer, O the servant of Allah, O servant of Abdul Rahman, O the soul of Allah, the Jesus, O Muslim, there is a Jew behind me. Come to kill him." Even the trees, even the rock, hate this kind of creatures, the worst kind of creatures, this kind of Jews, because they are very arrogant. They know the truth. They know that Muhammad is a messenger of Allah. They know that the Quran is the word of Allah. They know that Islam is the only religion of Allah. They know that Moses was a Muslim. Moses came with Islam. They know that David and Solomon, they know that Jonah, they know that Zechariah, they know that John and Jonah, they know that Jesus and Mary came with one religion, Islam, but they still rejecting the religion of Allah, still refusing the religion of Allah, still, you know, like denied and belied the words of Allah Azza wa Jal. So, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was like telling us about this kind of creature, that they are the worst enemy for the believers. They are mocking Allah and making a mockery, you know, of Allah and his religion and his word and his messengers. And even for Moses, even for Solomon and David, even for Jesus, they try to kill him, and they admit loudly, clearly, that we killed the Jesus, the son, the word of Allah, the son of Mary, we killed him. So this kind of the enemy, and they tried their best to kill the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the poison or magician or magic, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. They are the enemy of the human. So trees and rocks are believing and hating this kind of creature, not just the human. They know that Jews are the enemy, or the most enemy of the humanity. So Jews, so the trees and rocks recognize that and worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with this kind of worship by, you know, by hate them and telling showing the believers or the Muslims that there is a Jew behind me, come to kill him. Except one kind of tree, Shajar al-Ali, the trees of Gharqad, the trees of the Jew. And the Prophet ﷺ was you know, talking about that was telling us that except this kind of Jew. So, and Jews now, they are, you know, planting this kind of trees a lot because they know, they recognize, they know for sure, and they understood for sure that this kind, the only kind of trees will hide them, but the other trees will talk against them. That's what that means. That's a sign, miracle from Allah. They know this, you know, they know this news and this history. They know that the future is for Islam and for Muslim, but they're still arrogant and still denying that, still rejecting that even this kind of creature, the what we call like the, for this rock, like unliving or the other, or unmoving. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing that this kind of unliving creature, you know, or unliving creatures, they are the enemy of the Jews. They hate the Jews. They boycott the Jews. So they are, you know, according the request of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this kind of rocks worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, no one can recognize alive or the kind of worship of this like creature or this rock. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal, telling us that this kind of creature worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hating for the sake of Allah, loving for the sake of Allah, giving for the sake of Allah, denying for the sake of Allah. So from this, back to the same aqidah of, you know, of al-wala wal-bara, that even the rocks and trees believing and acting according to the same. According to the same, they are also reacting according to the pleasure of Allah or displeasure of Allah. So only the human who are mixing and who are lazy for this or are rejecting this kind of aqidah, to love for the sake of their desires or to hate for the sake of their own desires. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like telling us subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly that we have to say the truth, we have to deliver. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking about some ummah from the Jews, and وَإِذْ قَالَتْ أُمَّةٌ مِّنْهُمْ لِمَ تَعِذُونَ قَوْمًا اللَّهُ مُهْلِكُهُمْ أَوْ مُعَذِّبُهُمْ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us about some kind of the history of this kind of people, the advisor, when the advisor and reminder tried to correct and try to stop their people, their, you know, the sinners or the wrongdoers from doing, from acting, you know, against the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the Jews. And the scholars or their scholars try to advise them, to correct them, to change, to advise them, to teach them the correct way. So some kind of other people, they were blaming them. Why you are, you know, bothering yourself advising these people or spending the time to advise somebody who they are already, Allah decided to destroy them. Leave the sinners alone and just keep yourself or protect yourself or stay away. Do not bother this kind of people because they already, you know, will destroy, will be destroyed. Allah will destroy them. So Allah will punish them and put them in hell. Just like such as people are trying now to say or to discourage the advisors or the scholars or people who are enjoying good and forbid evil. Stay alone from this kind, just take care of yourself and leave the world for Allah, leave the world for these people. They and start blaming or stopping the advisors from enjoying good and forbid the evil. So the advisors answered them, respond them, قَالُوا مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ. We have to say the truth. We have to act. We have to practice this kind of aqidah. We have to enjoy good and forbid evil. We have to advise for the sake of Allah other for to be excused in the sight of Allah, and they may be guided, they may to change their way, or they may correct and change their way. They may, you know, stop from this sins and from, you know, disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah azza wa jal open our heart to recognize that. May Allah subhanahu revive our heart to practice and to react according to the pleasure of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deeds. May Allah open our heart. May Allah open our tongue. Always to say the truth, to advise for the sake of Allah, to correct people and to say that to be excused that we deliver the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then maybe this kind of people will change or correct their way, and then Allah will reward us with everyone we, you know, will guide. May Allah open our heart, may Allah accept our deeds, may Allah forgive all of us for our quiet, for our silence, for our, you know, division. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله تعالى لي ولكم جزاكم الله خيرا.